Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to look at how we can create a trading robot. Basically, a robot that can open and close trades based on the RSI indicator. So an example of that would be this. It doesn't ask to go through what we want the robot to do. So in this case, I'm just going to insert an RSI. There we go, where is it? So usually an RSI has a period and the apply to. So in this case, you're going to look at a period of 14 and then apply to close, and then we just get it there. So what we want this robot to do is that whenever the RSI line crosses above 80, so we can just fix that here, levels. So we want it in such a way that when it crosses 80, we sell, and then when it crosses below 20, we buy, correct? So, and then our take profits, or, okay, in this case, we're not going to include take profits or stop losses for now, but then I would just want the trade to close when the RSI, in the case of a buy, so let's just look here quickly. So this is what I wanted to do. When it comes here on top, okay, let's just use here. So when it crosses below, we want it to buy. And then when it reaches or goes above the 50, line. So let me just add another one, 50. So when it crosses above this line, it must close the buy, right? Same with the sell. If it crossed over here, we sell. And then when it crosses below this 50, it closes the sell. So that is basically the logic behind the indicator, the expert advisor that we want to create now. All right, so we're going to get straight into it. I'll start off with my code. Again, we start off with the simple things of including the trade class. And then after including that, we create an instance of the trade. I've taught on this. I think in my object-oriented programming, yes, I've taught on this. If you can have a look at one of my videos, you'll see it there. I taught about classes and all those things. So in this case, we have our inputs. So these are basically the RSI inputs, right? So this is the handler, stores the data, and then we have the MA period. So in this case, we want the user to input it, or actually this will allow me in this case to change the period. And then again, it also allows the user to input or change the price. So let me just go back there and show you what this means. So in this case, it will allow me to change the period. So this one, it has a period of 14, then it's applied to the close. So what that EA will do is that it will allow us to change the period as well as change the application there. So I'll just go back there. Then in this case as well, I have included an input for the lot size. I want to enter the lot size that I want. And then bars total and bars. Then we have the Boolean there for trade. This is going to help us to determine when we can place a trade. And then we have the position limiter. So in this case, I want to limit the number of trades open every single time. Because if you don't do that, in some cases, you'll see with every tick, it will keep opening trades and they can blow your account. Then we come to the function. So I taught about functions. And you will see that in this tutorial here, I've actually used functions. So I've created a function that opens a trade. I've created a function that closes a trade. I have also created a function that limits the number of trades opened, right? So that is what I've done now. And then you see that in the onTick function, I actually call those functions out, right? So let's go to the top. Again, this is a straightforward EA. We just wanted to open trades when, for example, it must open a buy when the RSI line goes below 80, below 20, and then open a sell when the RSI line goes above 80. Yes. So in this case, this is my function for opening a trade. We start off with the RSI line. This is an array. So we're going to store the RSI's details in this array. Then we use the copy buffer. I've explained this again in one of my videos. And then bars total. You'll see that if you come to the on tick, is it on tick? Yes. So this allows us to only open a trade on the completion of a bar. So what does that mean? Let me just show you here quickly. So I'm going to change the time frame to a minute. So what you would see is that price is constantly moving. So in this case, I don't know why price is not moving now. Oh, actually, yeah, it's still moving. So every time the price moves, there's a high possibility that, not even a high possibility, every single time your price moves on the on tick function, it will trigger a trade. But we don't want that. We want a trade to open only when the bar has been completed. So we use the bars there. If you look at this, we use this to say, okay, we can only open trades on the closing of the bar. Instead of every single time the price goes up and down, we only want to take a trade once the bar has closed, right? So that's very crucial. And then, so then, yeah, there we go. So in this case, as long as the bar hasn't completed, we don't want a trade. So whenever the, that's why you see here we have the trade true. So in this case, bars total, if the bars total is equals to bars, then and trade. So we can only open a trade when the bar has completed. Also when the trade boolean is true, right? That's the only time we can, or a trade can open. So in this case, where do we find this boolean? Where is this boolean affected? Now you see here that it's a boolean and it's equals to true. But if you go down to the limiter, trade limiter function, you'll see that whenever we reach our maximum number of trades, it equates the boolean to false. The boolean becomes false. So in this case, whenever the boolean is false, we cannot open a trade. But as soon as the trade limit is not equals to the position limiter, then our what? Our boolean is or remains true. Then we can open a trade. So that's how this trade limiter works. Again, remember, the trade limit equals the total number of open positions. And then this is our user defined. This is the one we input. For example, we can say we want the EA to open a maximum of 5 trades, only 5 trades every single time. So in this case, if the total number of trades in our chart is 5 and it's equals to the position limiter of 5, then it will make the boolean false, which means that our trades will not open anymore until some of the trades have closed. Then afterwards, then it will make the boolean true and allow us to open a trade. Again, this is simple. Again, what we want it to do is for it to open a buy, we want to open a buy when our RSI line is below 20, and when it's above 80, we open a sell. And I showed that example here that when it's above here, we must sell, and when it's below here, we must buy. And then we go back now down to the trade, the function that closes the trade. So in this case, again, we use copy buffer and store the RSI's details or information inside an array. In this case, we want to close the trades. Remember, I said that I want the trade for the sell. When we sell, the trade must close when the RSI line goes below or equals, or when it's below or equals to the 50 line. And for the buy, I want the RSI or the trade to close once the RSI has crossed above the 50 line. So then when you look at this, This here is to help us close the sell position. So what this does is, when we've reached our positions, that the total number of positions, right, that are open, or not even the total number of positions. So in this case, this here allows us to get each position that is open. And then once it retrieves that position using the ticket number or ticket type, it will check if that position type is a sell or a buy. That is basically what this is. It checks if it is a sell position or a buy position. And if it is a sell position, then it will close the sell position. Remember, it only closes the sell or the buy position whenever, in the case of a sell, if our RSI line is below or equals to the 50. In this case, I'll just call it the 50% line. So, and then it will close the buy position when the RSI line has crossed above or is equals to the 50% line, right? So that is how our trade closes. Then you come, I already explained the limiter, the trade limiter. It helps us to limit the number of trades we want opened at a time. And then we come down, I've taught this as well, that you initialize, or basically we put down the handler for the RSI in the on init function. And then afterwards, now since the on tick is always moving, it's constantly moving, that is where now we are always checking our bars and to make sure that what the bars or our trades open once a bar has completed. And then again, here we will call our trades or our functions once that is done. So guys, this is basically the code for the RSI EA. So we're going to test it out now. First, let's compile and see if there's no errors. Okay, there is no errors. And then what I'm going to do now is to debug. Let's just test it out on, okay, it has already started. So this is an example of how we debug, right? You can see that it is moving, but we want it to at least cross above 80 and see it open a trade. I'll just slow it down a bit. Can I increase the pace? Okay. We just wanted to open a buy or sell. Okay, I see it opened trades and it closed them. I moved on too quick. There we go. So it opened, it has opened buys. Now we need to watch. So the 50% line is somewhere here. So you should close the trade once it has touched above on close of the candle. There we go. So you see, so it opened the trades there. And once the candlestick closed above the 50% line, it closed the trade. And if you backtest this more and more, you see that it does the same thing with the sell. That is basically what this EA does. And again, this is not a strategy. It's just a way to help those that want to create their own expert advisors. It's just to help them to see, okay, this is how I can do this and this is how I can do that. You might have a technical or indicator-based strategy, and trust me, you can definitely transform that into an EA. So yes, guys, and the other thing is, I actually ended up creating this. So I have this document that explains each part of the code. If you see here, it looks at the first part of the including, the libraries, the trade, and then it goes down to explain what the purpose is. And then the second part, which looks at my indicator and the input parameters. These are all my input parameters. Then it explains the purpose. Then we look at each function and the purpose of the function. So now, guys, if you would like to get your hands on one of these, just comment your email address and then I will send that to you via email. But yeah, guys, that is it for this video. I wish you guys an awesome time. Thank you.